brothers and sisters. Ay, iba pala, tatawagin ko kayo. Good evening, Wednesday people. Tignan nyo nga yung katabi nyo, mukha ba siyang Wednesday people? O Wednesday person, whatever. Alam nyo, sino dito naka-attend nung anniversary ng feast? Ano bang, last Sunday? Ayan, wow. Ano yung team natin? Yung team? Perfect love. Do you want to receive God's perfect love this evening? I want you to stand, everybody. And let's worship our God. Just look to the sun. He's there. And He will always be with us. Are you ready? Say, I'm ready. Come on, put your hands together.
Set our eyes on our Savior, be the image of love, sing His praises forever.
I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Brother Yo. My real name is Joseph. Pero sa lagi ko sinasabi na Yo is a Japanese name that means sunshine. That's why I literally shine. Pero pinalitan ko na yon. Tanungin niyo ako ano? Rain or shine, Yo shines. Brothers and sisters, this is our moment with God. Amen. Last Sunday, we celebrated the 10th year anniversary of Feast Alabang, the district. And hindi nyo may imagine na limang feast na pala ito. I myself is the discipleship pillar and the worship leader of Feast SM South Mall. And I couldn't imagine, parang hindi ko mag-grasp. I can't fathom the love of God, His perfect love. And His movement continues. Our Christianity, our faith, our Catholic faith continues. It will never stop. Amen? Sino ba nagsimula niyan? I just want to share with you a verse from John chapter 1, verse 14 to 16. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have hold His glory as the only Son from the Father. John bore witness to Him and cried, "This was He whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks before me, for He was before me.' And from His fullness have we all received grace upon grace." Hallelujah. Let's come before God in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Let's receive God's love. Let's receive God's grace. It's overwhelming. It's unfathomable. It's the grace of God.
You still the oceans at your call, and at your whisper mountains fall. All of creation in your control. Jesus, you wait, you wonder.
Before God. give glory to our God. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen and amen. Let's give God a clap of praise and make some noise. Come on.
Praise the Lord. All those who believe that they are going to be blessed today, give a shout to Him right now. Yeah. Amen. Could you please tell the person beside you, I'm a believer. Pakisabi, I'm a believer. Yung mga hindi nagsabi, hindi kayo believer. Ulitin po natin, I'd like you to see, be conscious, say this to the person beside you with a smile, say that to the person, say that, I'm a believer. Come on, go. I'm a believer. Now for those who are not sure about what they're saying, we're just saying this, ask me what? That we believe in a God who blesses and loves His people. Amen? And so if you're saying that I believe that I'm going to be blessed today, then that is what's going to happen. Amen? Amen. Give a hand to the Lord. Woo. Welcome once again, dear brothers and sisters, to WFFA. This is your midweek break. This is where love connects, and this is where you are loved. Could you please turn to the persons around you with a smile, shake their hands, at least four people, all right? Either you shake their hands or you give them a high five, okay? And just say to that person, I am glad that you're here. Say the name, get to know the person, all right? After that, you say, I'm glad you're here. Is that okay? All right? Four people at least. Ready? Go! Come on. I'm glad you're here. I'm glad you're here. Come on. Get as many people around. Get people to come and fill up the chairs. Let's give a hand to the Lord. I have a test for you. Ask me what? Turn to the four people that you just met, point at them, and shout out their name. All right, ready? Go! Kyle, Joel, Carol, Lynn. Let's give a hand to the Lord. Come on. Praise Jesus. Welcome to the culture of WFFA. We want you to connect with people. Amen? Yung mga sanay na sumunod o pumunta sa mga ibang prayer gathering, naman lang hindi kayo makakilala ng isang bagong kaibigan. Dito po sa WFFA, ayaw ho natin yun. Gusto natin, kung nandito ka, at least may bagong kaibigan kahit isang tao man lang. Amen? No? Hindi ka pwedeng hindi pansinin kasi kapansin-pansin ka kay Lord. Amen? Amen. But para hindi kayo masaya dito. Alright? We'd like to welcome everybody. Today, meron bang dito, nandito, first time mo nandito. Please raise your hand. First time. Wow! Palapakan naman natin. Yahoo! Amen! Welcome. Nabalitaan ko merong taga Jollibee ba dito? Yan, no? We'd like to welcome the delegation ba? Delegation of Jollibee. Who just came here. Thank you. Welcome to the feast. We're glad that you are with us. All right. This is about them coming. It's not about Jollibee, okay? But nung nabalitaan ko na darating po kayo, I was just trying to psych myself up. Na imagine nagpre-preach ako dito, tapos biglang nandyan si Jollibee na gumaganon-ganon sa akin. Pero okay lang naman. But friends, we'd like to welcome everybody. Kung katabi nyo ang isang first-timer, pakisabi naman sa kanila, welcome! Pakisabi naman. Welcome, welcome to the feast. Amen. Friends, I'd like to also welcome you to our newest series. Our series for this next 4 weeks is entitled Creed.
Right? For those who just came in, you know, the feast is not just a prayer gathering. It's a gathering where you can learn a whole lot of things and get to know new people. This 4 weeks will be a powerful exposition of whatever we believe in. All right? Tignan nyo yung inyong katabi. May conviction ba yan? Tignan nyo nga. Yan. Wala pa akong pinag-uusapang kwana, preso. Hindi. No, no. Pag sinabing conviction, paniniwala yon. Paniniwala. And that, in English, is known as the creed. Who are expecting to be blessed today? Again, raise your hand. Amen. Now, I'd like, for those who raise their hands, I want you to listen to me. Are you ready? For those who are expecting to be blessed, guess what? Ask me what? You will. You will. Amen. Amen. If there's one thing that all faith communities, kung ano man ang relihiyon, kung ano man ang paniniwala ninyo, it's this, what you believe in becomes true. Ganun yun eh. Ganun yun. And that's why, as we're gonna pray this declaration of abundance, I'd like you to believe in every word that you're gonna declare. Now, pag-believe, hindi lang yan sa isip, dapat narinig sa salita, dapat nakikita sa mukha. Tingnan ang mukha ng inyong katabi. Yan. Ready na bang mabless? Nahangiti na ba? Kasi paano ka mabless kung nakasimangot ka, di ba? Dapat ready ka mabless, nakasmile ka na. Ngayon pa lang, habang ide-declare mo yung blessing ni God, nakasmile ka na para ready mong kunin. Amen? Alright? This is not hype. It is true. If you will now find the latest science, faith is not about what is. Faith is about what you believe that what is. Alright? There was a study, 1980s pa to, yung mga taong napaka-critical, mga analyst, mga ganyan, scientists, as opposed to a group na dreamers. Alam mo yung dreamers? No? Futuristic thinkers, ganyan, no? Two groups were compared. After 10 years, they looked into their lives. Meron isang grupo mas successful kaysa sa isang grupo. Tanong, sino yung mas successful? Yung mga analyst o yung mga dreamers? Parang, paano nyo alam yun? Ayan. Ang sagot tama, dreamers. The dreamers were more successful than the analysts. Bakit? Bakit? Hindi ba okay na mag-analyze? Hindi ba okay na maging realistic? Ganyan. Okay yun. But, everybody say, but, what happens is what you focus on in your life. So if you focus on your present, the real things. Are you following me? Yung realidad mo ngayon lang. If that is what you focus on, remember what we say, what you focus on grows. What you focus on expands. So kung ano yung nakikita mo ngayon lang, yun lang ang lalaki. But the dreamers, they didn't focus on what is. They looked at what could be. Alright? The dream, the future. And since that's what they focused on, that became their reality. Brothers and sisters, as we declare abundance in our lives, huwag niyong isipin lahat ng problema niyo ngayon. Huwag niyong isipin lahat ng alam nating realidad ngayon. Antignan nyo, kaya nga may faith. There is something beyond what we see. It is not what you see is what you believe. It is what you believe is what you will see. That is what our faith is saying. And so, brothers and sisters, may I invite you now to come from your heart. Pagkasabi puso, tignan ang katabi, may puso pa ba? Punong-puno ng kolesterol? Hindi. Sana punong-puno ng paniniwala. Ipakita ang paniniwala with a smile. Ipakita ang paniniwala with open hands or at least an open body position. Mahirap maniwala na kaganito ka. I believe. Hindi, di ba? I believe. And do this from the heart. Are you ready to declare God's blessing? Then, let's come before God in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Together, declare, today, I receive all of God's love for me. Today, I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe. Today, I open myself to God's blessings, healing, and miracles. Today, I open myself to God's word so I become more like Jesus every day. Today, I proclaim that I am. Come on, I am. I am God's powerful champion. And because I am blessing the world. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Brothers and sisters, it's just so apt that we say thy word is a light, is a lamp. Because all of us are living in darkness. Pakisabi, darkness. Tingnan lang katabi, may darkness ba yan? Hindi po skin ang tinitignan nating darkness. Darkness sa buhay. Sino dito may darkness sa buhay? May kadiliman sa buhay. Ayan. Friends, whatever darkness you are in, you've come to the right place because this is the place where the light is. Jesus is our light. And His Word will be a light into your darkness. Do you believe that? And so, friends, again, welcome to our series known Creed. Our first talk is conviction. This main message we have for tonight is this. Please read it. I'm a believer. And I'd like you to really believe it in your heart that since you are a believer in Jesus, you're a believer in God, then life will never be the same again. As the start of our talk is conviction, know that the next few weeks we'll also talk about other things that the Lord has given us. Communion, commission. These are gifts that God has given us. Even in our ancient creeds. Baka akala nyo, isa lang yung credo natin. Maraming creeds, pag-uusapan natin yan ngayon. Ngayon, for many of you who will say this and see this, sasabihin nila, naman brother, noon, stress. Noon, life stages ang pinag-uusapan natin. But ngayon, biglang creed para ako magkakatikisim uli. Ba't ako na religion class? Ang boring naman. What does that have to do with my relationships? What does that have to do with my money, with my family, with my work? Friends, I have an answer. Ask me what? Everything. It has to do with everything. Because, friends, what you believe in becomes your reality. What you believe in becomes your reality. So if you're asking me, anong kinalaman yung lahat sa buhay ko? Eh, lahat? Kasi kung anong paniniwala mo, yan ang buhay mo. Alam niyo ba yan? Friends, I tell you, if may mga idol ba kayo? May mga pinapangarap kayong mga position sa buhay, mga gustong mangyari rin, katulad ng mga idol natin, ganyan, no? Iba ang paniniwala nila, kaya nandyan sila. Are you following? Di ba? Ibang paniniwala nung mga, let's say, successful na tao, mas successful. Alam kong successful naman tayo. Amen? Tignan nyo ang katabi ninyo. Successful ba yan? Yung may ba? Wala man lang. Umiti lang. Parang, ganun lang. Hey, you better declare that you're successful. Because if you don't declare you're successful, who else will say that? And you will not be that. Alright? Yes? Because you define your success. Tama? You define your success. So ngayon pa lang, define it already and say that you're successful. It has to be here first. You know, as you know, I'm a coach, I'm a trainer, I'm a consultant. I teach this in so many ways, in so many workshops. Pero I just have less than an hour to share this with you. Friends, ngayon pa lang, what is your best self? What is your perfect self? What is yourself in the greatest vision of the grandest version? Tignan nyo ang katabi ninyo. May i-improve pa ba yan? Yes or no? Yes! Di ba? Kailangan ba yan ng makeover? Ano kayang itsura niya pag may makeover? Mas grabe, mas maganda, mas guwapo. Amen? Sino dito gusto nyong maging mas successful? Raise your hand. Are you sure? Then, even now, act as if you are. Talk as if you are. Think as if you are even now. Amen? Palapakan natin si Lord. Do that. That's why our basis for this whole series, friends, is what? Belief. Dapat maniwala ka na muna. And I tell you, at the end of this series, you will find miracles happening in your life. Friends, please read this. The creed defines who you are. The creed defines who you are. Ah? Pag-uusapan natin ito. Because beliefs impact behavior. What you believe in will be your behavior. Alright? Kung akala mo hindi ka magaling, paano itsura mo? Paano ang stance mo? Pero pag believe ka magaling ka, your posture is great. Right? Okay. There's an old musical known as The King and I. And then there was a kid who went to an Asian country from England. Sabi niya sa nanay niya, in English accent, "I'm afraid, Mom. I'm afraid. So afraid." Okay? Kasi nga, puro warriors ang nandun. Sabi ng nanay niya, "Act as if you're brave." Everybody say brave. Siyempre, naging normal na English na lang, no? Ayan, no? This is the title. Title talaga. It's what's printed on my shirt. Everybody say brave. And I believe, as we are launching also KCON 2019 today, this theme of bravery is all aligned with our series of creed. You know why? Ask me why. Bravery is acting as if you can, even if you can't. Sabi nung nanay sa anak niya, act as if you're brave. Kaya may kanta, and this is an old song, I'm sure the younger people will not know it. Sabi nung bata, "Whenever I am afraid, I hold my head erect and whistle a happy tune so no one will suspect I'm afraid." Ganon. So, kunyari, he's brave. But, everybody say but. Pag kunyari lang brave ka, at the end, ano yun? Kahit kunyari brave ka, kunyari nandyan yung kalaban mo, kunyari brave ka, o tas nagawa mo, ano yun? Hindi na kunyari yun. Matapang ka na rin. Kasi nagawa mo eh. Amen? And that is what you call faith. Even if you think you can't, you choose to believe and it happens to you. Again, who wants to be successful? Alright. So stop wishing it. Start doing it. Start believing it. I'm successful. And all the things that I will have to do to be successful, I will do it. I can. You need to believe. Pakitapik niyo yung katabi, pakisabi, you gotta believe. Because beliefs impact behavior. Are you ready for the word of God? Yes? Read this together from Romans chapter 10, verse 9 and 10. Together. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is with your heart that you believe and are justified, and it is with your mouth that you profess your faith and are saved. Who here believes that Jesus is Lord? Yung mga hindi nag-raise ng hand, ano pininiwalaan nyo? Friends, talaga? You believe Jesus is Lord? Yes or no? So, pwede tayong pumunta ng Baguio ngayon. Ha? Anong connection ng Baguio? Ganito lang yon. Taga-Baguio po ako. Yung mga hindi nakakaalam, taga-Baguio po ako. At palagi pag November 1, takot na takot ang mga taong pumunta ng Baguio. Bakit? Kasi we are known for our ghosts. Tama-tama, August is a ghost month. Tama? Tama-tama nagsasabing ganyan. Takot na takot pumasok sa White House ng Baguio. Pumunta sa teacher's camp ng Baguio. PMA, ha? Lahat ng mga sinabi ko, yan na. Yan yung mga storya. Kaya nyo matulog? Mag-isa. Doon. Friends, why am I asking this? Ask me why. Because if you believe that Jesus is Lord, it doesn't matter if this house is haunted. Because Jesus is Lord even of that house. Do you believe this? Marami ng mga tao, Believer, pagpasok sa isang haunted house, na kung lahat ng mga tao may nararamdaman, nagkakasakit, nagpapakita, sa kanya wala lang. Walang nangyari. Si Brother Bo, pumunta ng Baguio, natulog sa isang bahay na 24 hours na alam nilang may mga gumagalaw, may sound, ganyan. Wala, nandun lang siya. Wala naman nangyari. You know why? Because to him, Jesus is Lord. And if Jesus is Lord, he is Lord over all the ghosts, all the spirits, or whatever is there. They don't have any power over you because you are a follower, a believer of God. Amen? So ngayon pa lang, sabi ko, grabe itong series na to eh. Ngayon pa lang, friends, if you are under influence of the occult, if you are under the influence of any evil, surrender to God. Surrender to God. Yun lang yon. And you are released from that evil. If ever there's anyone here who has an anting-anting, anyone here who has any amulet or material that is from, alam niyo yung mga ganyan, yung mga encanto ganyan, I ask you, just burn it. Ask for holy water, basbasan nyo, or better yet, go to a priest, surrender nyo na. Yun lang yon. Go to Jesus. Surrender your life to Jesus. And your life will never be the same again. Jesus is Lord. Amen? And I'm not saying this out of religious jargon lang. No, it's fact. So if he is Lord over all kinds of spirits in the universe, he is Lord of your life. Remember, everybody read. Beliefs, impact, behavior. So, tapikin ang katabay, pakisabi, huwag ka nang matakot. Amen? Do you believe in the creed? Anong sabi? I believe, say it with me, I believe in God, the Father, pakisabi, Almighty. So, do you believe that God is Almighty? Do you believe that God is all-powerful? Yes. So, sino dito naniniwala sa horoscope? Siyempre, walang mag-raise ng hand. Sino dito? Taurus. Taurus. Meron man Taurus? Ayan, meron. Sinong Virgo? Virgo. Ayan, Virgo. Aries. Aries. No, Gemini. Ayan. Cancer. Ayan, no? Sagittarius. Meron? Ayan. Pisces. Ayan. Sino pa hindi ko natawag? Aquarius, Capricorn, tignan nyo yan, alam nyo? Akala ba hindi ko naniniwala? Eh, hindi, okay lang naman yung alam nyo. But friends, the horoscope is not God. God is God. He is real. Amen? So if He's all-powerful, let Him be all-powerful in your life. You know why we're not experiencing God's power? Ask me why. We're not letting Him. We're not letting Him have the power over our lives. I tell you, if you let Him become the power in your life, you will experience Him. Pero pag patingi-tingi lang ang paniniwala nyo kay Lord, patingi-tingi rin ang mangyayari sa inyo sa paniniwala ninyo. Diba? Katulad nung yung tatlong taong tumalon ng cliff. Muslim, Buddhist, at saka Katoliko, diba? Oh. Diba? Ala. Talon siya, ala. Tapos, bang. Oh. Tapos sabi ng Buddhist, Buddha. Tapos, bang. Ganyan. Yung Katoliko, Jesus. Nung wala pa nangyayari, ala. Buddha. Joke po yun. Kung hindi nyo nag-gets, okay na. Friends, kung naniniwala ka, dapat totoong maniwala ka. Only then will the reality kick in. Do you get this? Yes? Tapikin nyo ang katabi nyo, pakisabi, narinig mo yon? I believe in the Holy Spirit. Who believes in the Holy Spirit? Raise your hand. Amen. So if you believe in that, there's no other spirit more powerful than the Holy Spirit. So huwag ka nang matakot sa multo. Ayan na. Yung mga iba parang nasyashock. Talaga, ganito. Oo. Wala akong rosario, wala akong holy water, wala akong ganito. Friends, if you are the son, the daughter of God, you are more holy than the other stuff that you have. Do you follow this? These things are only helps for faith. They are not anting-anting. Huwag niyong gamitin anting-anting ang rosario, ang cruz. These are all holy remembrances of the Lord. Pero dapat maniwala ka na muna dun. No? Kung ginagamit niyo parang anting-anting, hindi ho ganun yun. Dapat ikaw mismo maniwala ka kay Lord. Confess that Jesus is Lord. And take note, your life will never be the same. Amen? Pakisabi, I'm a believer! Bow down your head, close your eyes, put your hand in your chest, and say this prayer with me. Lord God, I believe in you. Thank you for the gift of faith. Send me your spirit and lead me into your truth. Set me free. Give me life. Speak to me, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Together.
Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path.
Give a hand to the Lord. Come on.
Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Amen, amen. Friends, with a smile, tell the person beside you, you gotta believe this. You gotta believe this. Please be seated. Grabe, yung mga iba na siya shock. I'm so excited. Ask me why. Because imagine if all of us will just really believe what we declare. Imagine what you will do to the world. So many people are not able to do the things in their life because they don't believe it. Sino dito may pangarap? Please raise your hand. Sino may pangarap? Wow! Pakitapik yun yung katabi ninyo. Pakisabi, kailan pa yan? Pakitanong, kailan pa yan? Diba? May pangarap tayo. Kailan pa yan? Okay lang kung kahapon lang yan. Eh pero kung last year pa yan, last year pa yan, ano nangyayari? You know why it's not happening? Ask me why. Hindi niyo talaga pangarap. Hindi, Brother Jay, pangarap ko talaga. Pangarap kong magkapamilya. Pangarap kong magkaroon ng bahay. Pangarap kong magkakotse. Pangarap kong umabroad. Ganyan. Eh kung talagang gusto mo yan, bakit wala pa? Eh kasi. What differentiates people who get their dreams and those who nearly get their dreams is 100% conviction. Everybody say conviction. Tapikin ng katabi, pakisabi, convict ka ba? I'm not talking about being a prisoner. But yes, I think I'm talking about being a prisoner. Ask me why. If you're a prisoner to your belief, yung 100% ang belief mo na ito, at hindi ka papayag na iiba yon. If you're 100% convicted that you want to really earn a certain amount, you will do anything to get it. Do you get it? If you're 100% committed to a relationship, no matter what happens, you are committed to that relationship, 100%. That is your belief. If you're 100% committed to lose weight, at biglang ngumiti kayong lahat. Diba? Then you will lose weight. Kung 100%. Ang problema, ask me what? 99% ka lang. Ang problema ng mga diets, alam mo yung ano? Ask me what? You will try it for 1 month. Diba ganyan? I'll try it. I'll try this diet. 1 month, 2 months. The fact that you say you're gonna try it only for 1 month, 2 months means you're just gonna do it for a limited period of time. Hindi 100%. Ano yan? So magpapapayat ka lang, tapos pagkatapos nung nakuha mo na yung pagkapapayat mo, balik ka na naman sa dati. Eh di syempre, dapat babalik ka. Tama? Until you decided to go 100%, ibig sabihin, lifestyle mo na yan. Hindi ka na masyadong kakain ng kanin, o mamimili ka na talaga ng healthy food. Yung may ba nasasaktan? Di ba? Friends, I cannot go on because I have so many things to teach you, but I'd like to share this. What you really believe is your reality. Friends, answer me. Do you remember your weight? Yes? Yung may ba? Ayoko nang maalala, Brother J. Do you remember your bank account? Yung laman. Do you remember your waist? Do you remember your relationship, the state of your romantic relationship? Yeah. Either you have one or not. Remember this. Whatever that is a result of your beliefs. Huh? Brother Jay, grabe. Ano yun? Ginusto ko na maging overweight ako? Ginusto ko na walang laman ang aking bank account? Ginusto ko na magka-break kami ng girlfriend-boyfriend ko? Hindi ko naman sinabing ginusto mo yan. Ang ito lang, resulta lang naman tinitignan ko eh. So wag niyo akong tanungin kung bakit. Ipakita nyo kung ano. Are you getting this? Tap the person beside you. Pakisabi, naintindihan mo ba? Because what you believe shows in the results in your life. Everybody say results. Who wants better results in their life? Yeah. So maybe you need to change your beliefs. Because your results now is a result of your beliefs now. If you want to change your results, change your beliefs so that your results will be better. Do you get it? In terms of faith, if your faith is not working right now, maybe you need to believe much more what you believe in. Or maybe that's why you're in this series, because you'll now know what you really believe in. Do you get me? So many people are nominal Catholics, nominal Christians. They say they're Catholic, they say they're Christian, but if you ask them, what do you believe in? Basta. Diba? Sarado, sagrado, katoliko. Ano nga ang pagkakatoliko mo? Basta. Eh, yun ang problema, hindi natin alam. Are you ready to know? Are you sure? Nandito na rin kayo, sayang naman. Okay? Let's do this then. Everybody say, I'm a believer. I'll be very quick. Are you ready? Take a deep breath. Sit well, please. Sit well. Come on. Sit well. Okay. This is what's going to happen. Read this. Tapos na yun. Ito na. Okay. Read it. Go. These are the two creeds. Statements of belief. That's a creed. It's a statement of your belief. Two creeds that we know. Apostles. Sino nakakalam na Apostles' Creed? All right. Memorize. Sino nakakalam na Nicene Creed? Memorize? Nawala na. Haba na Nicene, brother. Tama. Apostles, sinasabi natin yan sa rosary, sa baptism, sa renewal of baptism. Nicene, ginagawa natin sa misa. Tama. We may not find these creeds in the Bible, but what is expressed in the creeds are also expressed in the Bible. Take note, friends. 2,000 years ago pa ang dumating si Jesus. Ang dami nangyari since then. But this is one thing. Because of the faith of all our predecessor Christians, we have come up with our faith. Friends, don't you know the Apostles' Creed was formulated after 200 years. 200 years in the making ang Apostles' Creed. Ang Nicene Creed, mas mahaba, tama? It took 400 years to make the Nicene Creed. It was debated in councils of the priests and bishops of that time. Nung 200 AD, 300 AD, 400 AD, 500 AD, wala pa tayo dito. Friends, welcome to history a little bit. I have a question. Ask me what? Why would God develop with people all of these creeds during the centuries. Bakit ito ang nangyari sa paniniwala natin mga Kristiyano? I have four spiritual principles. How many principles? That we will learn this evening. Are you ready? Throughout history, we learn one spiritual principle. Show it. Number one is, together, God works through patience. Tignan niyo ang katabi ninyo. Patient ba yan? Malay ko, brother, no? Ganyan. Madaling magalit, madaling mainip. Friends, it took centuries for the faith to develop the creeds. How long? Ito. In the New Testament, meron ng mga credo na sinasabi ng mga tao. Ibig sabihin, meron ng paniniwala ang mga disipulo noon. Naalala niyo nung tinanong ni Jesus kay Pedro, "Who do you say I am?" Tama? Ano ang sabi ni Peter? Everybody read. "You are the Messiah, the Son of the Living God." That's a creed. Gets? That's a creed. He declared his belief. You are the Savior. Di ba? Nung nagpakita si Jesus kay Thomas, doubting Thomas, anong sabi ni Thomas? Ay, wala na. Mga Katoliko nga talaga kayo. Hindi alam ang script. Anong sabi? Remember? Ito yon. Show it, please. My Lord and my God. Diba? Sabi ni Jesus, "Look, I already have the wounds. I'm alive. My Lord and my God." So it's a declaration of faith. Face someone beside you. Pakisabi, "My friend, who is Jesus to you?" Pakisabi. Yan na. That's a declaration of faith. Yung mga nagsabing, "Friend ko siya." Yung mga nagsabing, "Siya ang Panginoon ko." Yung mga nagsabing, "He is my Savior. He is my healer." Then you know something. Pero yung mga ibang walang definition, maybe it's a challenge for you now. You need to define who Jesus is for you. Hindi yung Jesus lang siya sa'yo pag may earthquake, pag may bagyo, pag wala ng pera sa bangko. Brothers and sisters, asan ang mga students dito? Students! Parang ayaw man, dami students. One thing I notice always in schools, ask me what? Pag prelim, midterm, at finals, totoong-totoo ang Diyos. Grabe, puno ang chapel. Tama? Punong-puno yan. Grabe. Pag may kailangan lang, pero pag wala na, wala nang Diyos. Friends, God is more than just a helper. He's real. So maybe it's about time you define who is for you. Friends, don't you know that some Bible books known as the epistles were written before the Gospels? Yung mga the letter of Paul too, yung mga ganyan, nasulat pa yun earlier than the Gospel of John, for example. Hindi naka-arrange ang Bible chronologically by author. Don't you know Genesis was written after even the prophets? Huh? Akala ko ang unang nasulat ang Genesis. Kaya nga Genesis. Hindi po. Genesis was written after the other books of the prophets. Welcome to the fact that we know very little about the Bible and that we now are open to what? Learning more about the Bible. Amen? Kaya mandali tayong maguluhan eh. Kasi hindi natin alam ang Word of God. But welcome to the feast. We are going to help you. We're going to bring you closer to the Lord by knowing the Word of God. Amen? Amen. Now, alam ko, for many of you, boring yan. Naku, subject yan. Friends, we will not do this if it didn't change our lives. I tell you, you just need to discover. Everybody say, discover. Discover the power of the Word. All right? Understand this. The earliest creed was this. Let's all read. If you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. Para sa atin, parang hindi na napaka-importante noon. You know why? Kasi nung bata pa tayo, narinig na natin yan. Kasi narinig na natin yan, lalo na sa mga Catholic schools, di ba? Alam na natin yan. So parang hindi na significant. But friends, napaka-importante yan. Una-una, sinasabi, if Jesus is Lord, lahat ng ibang kapangyarihan, walang binatbat kay Lord. Gets nyo? That alone, ang lakas na ng loob mo. That alone, iiba ang buhay mo. you will not be afraid. Next, you believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead. You're saying that my life is not just here on earth. Tuloy-tuloy ako sa langit. Tuloy-tuloy ang buhay ko. Do you get it? Meaning that our life is not meaningless. There's meaning in our life. Next, I am saved. Ibig sabihin, someone loves me. Other people will not love me. Other people will not even take care of me. But someone loves me. And in his eyes, I am loved. Do you get this? So lahat ng duguan ang puso. Tingnan nyo ang katabi ninyo. Heartbroken ba yan?
Meron nakita ang mukha, sabi niya.
Friends, there's a scripture that says, God is close to the brokenhearted. Totoo yan. So you need to believe that. Imagine, friends, if you just know the word of God, ang dami mong discount sa psychiatrist. Tama. Alam niyo kung bakit may trabaho kaming mga psychologist sa psychiatrist? Kasi maraming taong hindi naniniwala kay Lord. Ang pinaniniwalaan ang TV, ang social media, ang paniniwalaan ang nasa Hollywood. 'Yun ang pinaniniwalaan kaysa yung sinasabi ni Lord. Kaya ang daming gulo-gulo buhay. Totoo lang. If we only follow the word of God, mawawalan kami ng trabaho. Mga psychologists at psychiatrists. I kid you not, I tell you. You know why? Ask me why. I taught abnormal psychology and psychopathology. Most of the interventions to help people recover from their psychosis and neurosis, tignan nyo katabi ninyo. Wala lang, pinapatingin ko lang, di ba? Kayo naman, mga judgmental na agad kayo. Neurosis, psychosis, ganyan, ganyan. Yan. Most of the interventions are all acts of love. Counseling, listening, holding hands, embracing, being with the person, forgiveness. All of that is God's word. Kaya nagkakasakit tayo kasi hindi natin pinapakinggan ang sabi ng gumawa sa atin. Are you listening? Kaya nagkakagulo-gulo buhay natin. We're not following the manual of our life. If you believe that God is the creator of your life, alam niya kung paano yung function mo. Tama? Now, if you don't follow the functions, magulo. Tapigin niyo ang katabi niyo, pakisabi, kamusta ka na? Ayan na. Brothers and sisters, read this. Whoever confesses that God is the Son of God, God abides in him and he in God. Who likes to abide in God? Sino dito gusto mong kakampi si Lord? Wow, ang grabe, no? Ang dami-dami. Gusto ko kakampi si Lord. Yan. Okay. Alam nyo, kampi ka ni Lord. Ang tanong, kumakampi ka ba sa kanya? Baka hindi ka kumakampi. Everybody take a deep breath. Friends, I want you to go a little historical. Are you ready? Historical na hindi hysterical. Okay? Historical. Noong unang panahon, 2,000 years ago, when Jesus came, Jesus resurrected, Peter, the new church, are you following me? Alright. Habang lumalaki yung church, may mga bagong converts. Tama? Tinuturuan sila ng catechesis. Ang tanong, they never heard Jesus. They never felt Jesus. So, ano alam nila? Dapat turuan. Tama? So, dapat sabihin sa kanila kung anong paniniwala. May credo. Gets? Diba? Dapat, for those who joined fraternities and sororities, lahat ng sumama ng sorority at fraternity, ngumiti sa akin. Ayan. Diba may initiation kayo? Diba? So, anong ginagawa sa initiation? Aside from the paddling, merong mga beliefs, tama? May mga code of conduct. May mga paniniwala. Ganun din. Hindi naman walang sampal. Ang sampal lang natin sa Kristiyano, yung sa kumpil, yung ganyan. But friends, the beliefs that we have are statements of faith. Here are the popular statements of faith. Read them. Let's show it, please. The Apostles' Creed, the year 120 to 250. The Creed of Nicaea, 325. The Nicene Creed, magkaiba yon, 381. The Chalcedonian Creed, 451. The Athanasius Creed, year 500. Ay, grabe! Ang dami pala. Dami. Friends, it took centuries to create the creeds. I said it before and I say it again. Please read this. God is never in a hurry. So, pag kayo, atat na atat, ang tagal naman, Lord! Say this together. It will come in God's perfect time. You need to trust. Kaya may faith, di ba? You need to trust. Grabe. That's the first principle. What is again? What's the first principle again? It is what? God works through patience. Kaya you need to have faith. The second principle is, everybody read. God works through problems. Sino may problema? Raise your hand. Yung maraming problema, dalawang kamay. Ayan. For those na mas maraming problema, congratulations. Congratulations. Totoo yan. Ay nako, totoo. You know why? Ask me why. Ibig sabihin, believe na believe sa'yo si Lord, kaya mo yung dalawang yan. I'm not joking. I'm not just making your spirits high. No. The fact that God allowed this to happen to you, ibig sabihin, kaya mo yan. Because He will not give you anything you cannot handle. 1 Corinthians 10:13 says, He will give you even a way out of it. He will not give you anything you cannot handle. So kung nandyan yan, kaya mo yan. You just need to figure out how to handle it. Huwag kang bumigay. You need to have faith. Do you understand? Remember, at the earlier part of the church's journey, ang daming ibang false prophets. Ang daming nagkagulo. Don't you believe? In 180 AD, ito ang nangyari. Read this. A person named Marcion. Pakisabi Marcion. Of course, he developed a belief known as Marcionism. Di ba? Anong tinuro niya? Ito. He taught that Jesus was sent on earth not by the Creator God, but by a higher God. Huh? Dalawang God, yun ang paniniwala niya. Bakit? Hindi niya ma-reconcile yung punishing God ng mga Jews at saka yung God ni Jesus na loving. Kaya sabi niya, siguro dalawa yung God na yun. Ito pang paniniwala niya, na si Jesus daw, nung dumating siya dito, hindi totoong katawan yun. Illusion lang daw, parang hologram lang daw si Jesus. Oh, grabe. No? Noon pa pala, meron ng hologram na naiisip ang mga tao. Ganun, naniniwala sila noon. Now, understand, the church fathers, pag sinabing church fathers, yung mga naunang mga bishop, sino yan? Epiphanius, Irenaeus, Tertullian. Sino yung grabe mga pangalan, di ba? All of them renounced Marcion, sinabi na, you're a false teacher. So many of these false beliefs are called heresies. Have you heard of the term? Heresy. A heresy is a false belief. Maling paniniwala. Ito po ang mga iba't iba. Would you be curious about what are the false beliefs? Nung unang panahon pa lang sa Catholic Church, ito. First, Arius developed Arianism. Ano ang paniniwala? That Jesus was just man. Hindi siya God. Laking scandal yan sa church. Noon, inayos, he was renounced. But friends, sa totoo lang, di ba? Meron yan ngayon. They believe that God is just man. Pero nung 200, 300, 400 AD, pinag-usapan na yan. Tapos na yung issue na yan. No. God, Jesus is both man and God. Kaya sa creed natin, di ba? Jesus is both man and God. Di ba sabi? Yan. Kasi we're defining it. Next, Gnostics had Docetism. Sige nga, ba't ako palagi nagsasalita? Kayo rin. Ba't ako lang ang mag-nosebleed? How do you read that? Gnostics. Yan. Hindi Gnostics. No? Gnostics. They developed docetism. Ano ibig sabihin yan? That the body of Jesus was just a hologram. Illusion lang. Di ba? Grabe. Parang Star Trek, no? Hmm. Next, Nestorius. Develop? Nestorianism. Yeah. Obvious ba? Ano sabi? Dalawa daw ang Jesus. May Jesus sa heaven, may Jesus sa earth.
Wow. Grabe, no?
Next, Manny. Hindi si Pacquiao yan, ha? Manny. Developed? Manichaeism. Ano sabi ng Manichaeism? Ask me what? Good and evil are equal. Tapos sabi niya, ano, lahat ng material ng bagay, masama. Kaya dapat spiritual ka lang. Lahat ng material, evil. Kaya poverty sila. Poverty, poverty. Ganon. Mali. Through richness, you can bless people. Are you still with me? Okay, ito para may basis yung faith natin. Next. Malapit na. Gnostics will also have what? Sige nga, go. Yan. Ano yan? Sabi, since we have grace, God's grace, we are not anymore morally bounded. Sabihin, wala nang good and bad sa atin. May grace naman eh. Tama ba yun? Na wala nang good and bad? May grace naman eh. Patatawarin naman tayo eh. So kahit magkasala tayo, magkasala, okay lang. Di ba? Hindi okay yun. Lastly, Pelagius created Pelagianism. Parang hirap, no? Pero obvious na obvious. Ano sabi dito? We can choose to do good without God's help. Yun yung teaching nila. Pwede kang maging mabait kahit hindi ka na kay Lord. Mali. All goodness is an expression of God's grace. Ganun yun. We believe that. Meron pang mga iba. Pansin nyo lahat. Pag-Arian, Arius, Arianism. Pelagius, Mani, di ba ganyan? Meron pang mga iba. Have you heard of Boism? Arunism? Di ba? Yung J-ism, konti lang yun eh. Ganyan eh. Joke lang yung joke lang. Peter said this. Please read. Ito. Everybody? False prophets appeared in the past among the people. And in the same way, false teachers will appear among you. They will bring in destructive, untrue doctrines and will deny the master who redeemed them. And so they will bring upon themselves sudden destruction. Friends, dahil ang dami-daming kaguluhan, ang daming heresy, gumawa ang simbahan ng credo para walang magkagulo, para magkaintindihan tayo. Do you get me? They were compelled to define, defend, and declare their beliefs. Without the heresies, without these problems, there will be no creeds. Buti na lang, may mga problema ang ito, kaya nagkaroon tayo ng credo. This verse is very true, friends, na kahit may problema ka, may magandang pwede mangyari sa problema. Pagkatapos, yes? Because we believe this. Please read. And we know that all things work together for good for those who love God. Amen. Kung may problema ka, later on magugulat ka, dahil sa problema na yan, may magandang mangyayari. Do you get me? Because God will not give you anything without purpose. May rason. Tapikin nyo ang katabi ninyo, pakisabi, nagigets mo ba? Everybody please read this. God will work through your chaos. God will work through your chaos. Last two. Mabilis na to. Third. Everybody read. God works through. Do you believe that? I believe that. Sino dito nanay? Ayan. Sino dito gustong maging nanay? Ayan. Sino dito may alagang bata? Ayan. Mga nanay, mga may nag-aalaga ng bata, have you tried cooking with your kid? Maraming tao sasabihin, ayoko nga, magkakagulo. Di ba? Pero I think you will believe this. If you try cooking with your kid, it is much more fulfilling. Yes? At parang walang nakapag-relate doon. Mas madali kayang yung walang gugulo. Pero pagkasama mo yung anak mo, kahit siya lang yung mag-ayos, may yung konti-konting gagawa, ibang klase yung pagluto. Friends, ganun din I believe si Lord. Okay na okay naman sanang sabihin niya, oh, ito ang katotohanan. Bam! parang 10 commandments, bigay ko kay Moses. Pero hindi eh. He did not give us the creed diretsahan. He gave us the creed through 500 years of working with people. Through their past, their difficulties, their experiences, their biases. Are you following me? He worked through people. Just like a mother or a father who will work with their kids to build a sandcastle. Pwedeng siya naman ang gumawa ng sandcastle. Mas maganda pa, mas efficient. Pero hindi, dapat kasama ang anak ko. Ganun rin ang Lord sa atin. Are you listening? You know why? Ask me why. Because God believes in you. God believes in us. He will listen to us. Love eh. Love. It's free. Dapat I work with you. Hindi pwedeng utos-utos ako. Pakitapik ang yung katabi, pakisabi kasama mo si Lord. Yeah, no. Last principle. Please read. God works through professions. God wants to use your mouth. Wow, what does that mean? A creed is a confession. Pakisabi confession. Let's all read from the Catechism of the Catholic Church. Let's all read this. Through the centuries, in so many languages, cultures, peoples, and nations, the Church has constantly confessed this one faith, received from the one Lord, transmitted by one baptism, and grounded in the conviction that all people have only one God and Father. Together, the Apostles' Creed is so called because it is rightfully considered to be a faithful summary of the Apostles' faith. It is the ancient baptismal symbol of the Church of Rome. Its great authority arises from this fact. It is the creed of the Roman Church, the See of Peter, the first of the apostles, to which he brought the common faith. One last. Through the centuries, in so many languages, cultures, peoples, and nations, it's a repetition. The Church has constantly confessed this one faith, received from the one Lord, transmitted by one baptism, and grounded in the conviction that all people have only one God and Father. Everybody, could you stand up? I want you to get a partner. Find a partner. Just one partner. One partner lang, just for now. Okay. Say hi, partner. Okay. I'm gonna ask you to do an exercise. Know the name of your partner. At the count of three, say the name of your partner. One, two, three, go. Yeah. Okay. Right. At the count of three, I want you to give another name to your partner. A pseudo-name. Another name. Magsabi ka ng ibang pangalan. No? One, two, three, go. Ayan. Okay. Determine who is partner A and partner B. All A's. Raise your hand. All A. 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 Come on. A. All A's. Down. B. 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 Okay, down. All A's. I want you to do this. Do this. Face your partner and do this. Okay. May I have a volunteer? Volunteer. Sino pupunta dito sa harap? Ayan. Brother. Palapakan naman natin ang ating brother. Come, come, come. Your name?
Wax.
Ano?
Wax.
Wax. Yun yung totoong pangalan mo?
Joaquin.
Joaquin. Ayan. Nakasya lang ngayon. Okay. Bro, what you're gonna do, Wax, is... Okay, Joaquin. Joaquin, para clear. I want you to just put your name like this, put your hand this way, okay? And I want you, ito, tingnan nyo lang na muna ha, okay? I want you to resist my putting it down, all right? Sige, go. Yan ha, okay. So say wax, okay? When I say something, you just resist, okay? All right, okay, all right. Say, I am walking, go.
I am Joaquin.
Pakisabi, I am girly. Go. I am girly.
I am girly. I am girly.
Ulitin natin. I am Joaquin.
I am Joaquin. I am green.
I am girly. I am Joaquin.
I am Joaquin. I am girly.
What did you notice? Pag sinabing Joaquin, pag Joaquin, may resist. Kaya diba? May resistance. Pero nung sinabing ibang pangalan, oh, huwag na ngayon kasi hindi nyo ma-atim na sabihin yun, diba? Okay. So, I am Mark. Pakisabi, I am Mark.
I am Mark.
Okay, sabihin mo naman, I am Joaquin. Go.
I am Joaquin.
I am Mark.
I am Mark.
Alright? Okay. So, I want you to try this out. So, the person will now say his name or her name first. Put it down. After that, the person will say the false name you gave him or her. Yes? All right? And try it out. Then after that, exchange with partner B. Yes? All right? Ready? And go. Come on.
Go.
O, yung isa naman, partner B. Let's give a hand to everybody. Woo. Friends, how was the experience? You noticed something? Yeah? Nung yung pangalan mo talaga, kaya mo. You're strong. You can resist. Pero nung ang sinasabi mo, hindi katotohanan. Hindi yung totoo, ang hina mo. Do you get me? Because the truth will set you free. The truth is your strength. And what you declare, if it's really your belief, that's what's gonna happen. If you don't believe what you say, it will not happen. Do you get it? You need to believe what you say. Tama na yung sinasabi ng kamunduhan. You know, friends, social media, the world that we have now, has so many words. Tama? Sang katutak ng information, information overload everywhere, that we think that words are no longer relevant, words are no longer important. May I have your attention, please? Look here. So many people think that because just so many people are saying their own opinion, words don't matter anymore. Friends, I have to say, words matter. What you say to yourself, what you say to other people, what you say to the world creates your reality. Words create worlds. And right here, right now, what you believe in will form the words that you say. Remember, the creed is a confession. If you confess it, that Jesus is Lord, then Jesus is Lord. Nothing else will be your Lord, but Jesus is Lord. And imagine what your life will be if Jesus is Lord. Hindi ka na wishy-washy. Hindi ka na mag-aalinlangan pa. Hindi ka na pa urong-sulong. Kasi Jesus is Lord. Tapos na. Tapos na yung argument. Kung sinong tama, Jesus is Lord. Kung sinong paniniwalaan ko, Jesus is Lord. Kung sino mas makapangyarihan, Jesus is Lord. Kung okay ang buhay mo, Jesus is Lord. Kung saved ka, Jesus is Lord. Kung yayaman ka, Jesus is Lord. Kung you're gonna be healed, Jesus is Lord. If you're gonna be happy, Jesus is Lord. If you can love, Jesus is Lord. If you can forgive, Jesus is Lord. Do you get this? Words create worlds, brothers and sisters. Friends, when God created the world, He did not create them with His own hands. He just set them into being. Let there be light, and there was light. He just said them. And so, brothers and sisters, right here, right now, as we start this whole series, I'd like you to declare the life you want. I want you to declare the faith that you believe in. And believe with every inch and fiber of your body what you believe in. Because you know what? Ask me what? In any minuscule way, in any way, if God created the world by saying it into being, since we are His children, guess what? We participate in that power. We can also create our world by saying it into being. You and I can declare the life that we want. And it will be. It will happen. Together, read this. We too can speak things into being. Do you get me? When you wake up in the morning, if you say, it's gonna be a bad day again. Hi, Monday na naman. Hi, mahirapan na naman. Hi, siya na naman ang papakausapin ko. Siya na, mukha na naman niya makikita ko. Ay, manghihina na naman ako. Guess what? What you say will happen. But if you wake up in the morning, this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. I'm gonna be successful. I'm gonna be happy. I'm going to love it. I'm just gonna love it. Sino dito burnt out sa trabaho? Or sa giving. Sino dito nahirapan sa ginagawa niya? This is one tweak that you can say. If you just really have to do it also anyway, if you just have to do it anyway, say this, wow, I get to do this. So many people don't get to do this. Do you get this? Declare the life you want. Don't declare what you don't want. Don't say paulit-ulit yung problema mo. What you center on grows. Do you get it? So what are you focusing on? What are you declaring to the world? That's what's gonna happen in your life, guys. So declare happiness. Declare order. Declare joy. Declare abundance. Declare it. When you confess your conviction, you say, for example, I'm God's beloved. Guess what? Ask me what? You define who you are. I am beloved. And that is what happens when you declare the creed. I believe in God, meaning that I come from God. The fingerprints of God are in my soul. The Father Almighty, He is my Father. I'm His child. I am loved. Almighty, He is powerful. Then no other can go against me. If God is for us, who can be against us? I am with God. Do you get it? And so this time, I'm going to ask you to do this. Ask me what? We will declare the Apostles' Creed. Are you with me? And I want you to say it from your heart. Yes? All right? Bahala kayo if you want to do this. If you want to do this, bahala kayo kung anong gusto ninyo. The important thing is this. When you say it now, come from your heart and declare it. And take note, everything that you declare will create your world from now on. Ito lang masasabi ko, ah. 2,000 years have come and gone, and people have died for this creed. Don't you know? In the first 400 to 500 years of the Catholic Church, so many people have died because of this creed. Because so many people have been trying to convince them, renounce your faith, or we're gonna kill you, we're gonna kill your family, we're gonna kill everybody in your life. I will stand by my faith. I stand by Jesus. There was even a saint, and I forgot his name. He was killed while he was on the road by some heretics. He was killed because he could not renounce his Apostles' Creed. And then after he was killed by his blood, it was shown that on the ground, he wrote, I believe in God. And then he lost his breath. That is the conviction of all those who have come before us. Friends, are you ready to declare your faith? Ito lang masasabi ko. If all of us now will believe what we declare, you can just imagine what kind of world we will now create in our lives where Jesus is Lord and where faith is declared and His Spirit will take over. Amen. Give a hand to the Lord, brothers and sisters. For we get to do this after 2,000 years. Are you ready to declare with the saints and angels, with the voices of people who have died for 2,000 years, what they have declared in their own languages throughout the world, throughout the centuries, who have said this in their churches and who have said this in their jail cells, who have said this while they were going to get hanged, who have said this while they're going to get killed, and they just said, I believe in my God and I believe by my life that this is true. Are you ready to declare WFFA? Let's come before God, the name of the Father, and the Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Together declare, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, sits on the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of the saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Bow down your heads and say this with me. I'm a believer. Lord God, thank you for everything you have revealed. You are my Lord. You are my Savior. May I declare now with all the saints and angels my belief in you. You are our Lord. You are Lord of all, O God. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Let's give a hand to the Lord. Worship Him now, brothers and sisters. As we sing this song, come from the heart, raise your hands and sing it with me. Jesus,
you still
to worship you and declare that you are our Lord and Savior. Jesus, you are Lord.
Jesus, you are.
And we believe that in the Father, in the Son, and in the Holy Spirit, you are more power in our hearts.
Yes.
We want to let go and let God right now.
Yes, Lord.
We want to let go of our fear. We want to let go of our shame. We want to let go of our worries. We
yes,
want to let go of our doubts. We would just declare
yes, Lord,
that you are the Almighty One. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. The Father everlasting, the all-creating One, God Almighty.
Amen.
Through your Holy Spirit, forget this.
I believe in life eternal. I believe in the virgin birth. I believe in the saints' communion and in your holy church. I believe in the resurrection, that Jesus will come again. For I believe in the name of Jesus. For I believe in the name of Jesus.
And yes, Lord, we believe in your name. If in the past we've been nominal Catholics, Lord, nominal Christians, and for many people they may think we are fanatics, singing, jumping around, raising our hands. But Lord God, people are jumping around, raising their hands to a person they don't even know in concerts. They're doing this to people they don't even understand who what they believe in. They do this to people in the programs. They do this to things that they are not totally knowledgeable about. Friends, I'd like to invite you now. Put your faith where your mouth is. If you believe with what you say, then go all out. Don't go 99%. Go 100%. If you believe in God, then make Him God of your life. And I tell you, your life will never be the same again. If we will reason out na fanatics yung mga yan or iba yung mga tao yan, well, anyway, ito lang yon. Why we're experiencing the level of faith and the results of our faith right now is because of our level of faith right now. Imagine if you go 100% with your faith. Imagine what kind of life you will start living. The reading for today was about a woman who went to Jesus who was not a Jew. And she said, Lord, heal my daughter. She is demonized. It's not right to get the food to the children and give it to the dogs. Sabi niya, but even the dogs get scraps from their master's table. Ang sagot ni Lord, woman, your faith is so great. Let what you say happen to you. And from then on, her daughter was free of the demon. By your faith shall your life be. And so, brothers and sisters, if you sing this, that you believe that God is your Father, guess what? You and I, we are children of Almighty God. Imagine the life. Declare it now. And let no other demon rule your life. Let no other belief tell you your life and what it means. Let Jesus be your Savior and Lord. Raise your novena to God's love. And with excitement, say this with me. Lord Jesus, thank you for the new life that you give us today. I am convicted that I am saved, I am blessed, and I declare that all my dreams will come true in Jesus' name. Amen. Woo. Let's declare. I believe
in God our Father. I believe in Christ.
We believe in you, oh God. Amen.
And amen. And amen. Tell the person beside you with a hug, with a handshake. Pakisabi na lang sa kanya. God believes in you. Come on, say it. God believes in you. Give it to as many people that you know. The four people you got to meet, say them by your name, by their name. Say it. God believes in you. God believes in you. Let's give a hand to the Lord once again, brothers and sisters. Please be seated. Whew. Friends, I realized one thing. Ask me what? The feast comes in different ways, right? Sometimes we're very emotional in a crying sort of way. Sometimes we're very emotional in a convicting side of way. I think today is the convicting side. Sino dito, you can't wait to get to work to change it. You can't wait to go to your friends. You can't wait to live the life that God has first in store for you. Who wants to say that? You can't wait to live the life that God has in store for you. Yeah? Yes? So just believe it, friends. Ngayon pa lang, imagine how your life will be if you really believe what you have just declared, that Jesus is Lord. We'd like to welcome our first-timers once again. Let's open the lights. Could we ask all those who have come here for the very first time to raise your hand? Asan kayo? Ayan, ayan. Palapakan naman natin sila. Could you stand up? Could you please stand up alongside with those who invited you? Palapakan natin sila. Wow, wow. Welcome. We'll pray for you right now while you're standing. Could you just bow down your heads? Everybody, let's raise our hands towards our... If someone is standing, just raise your hand towards that person in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh God, we thank you for all our new brothers and sisters who have come. We pray that you will bless them powerfully, that you will answer their prayers of healing, of success, of love, of abundance. In whatever way, grant them, Lord, the prayers they have in their heart. And may they come back to WFFA knowing that you love them. This we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. Let's give a hand. Thank you so much. You may be seated. After this, please visit our new attendees corner. We're going to give you a welcome gift. And may welcome gift. Let's praise the Lord for 440 people today. Praise God. Friends, marami pang mga empty chairs. You think some people will benefit from being here? Yes? No, not just with the talk, but just by the atmosphere. No, please bring them along and let's fill up the chairs because there's so many spaces still for so many people. It's August, people of God. We'd like to greet our August celebrants. Asan po ang mga birthday celebrants? Please stand up. All those who are celebrating their marriage anniversary, stand up also. Palapakan natin ang mga birthday celebrants. Also, our marriage celebrants, no, anniversary. Those who are standing, please bow down your heads. We'll pray for you again. Let's raise our hands towards those who are standing. That in the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Lord, we pray for all those who are celebrating their birthday this year. We pray that you will grant them breakthrough this year. May this year be the best year ever. May they have answered prayers. May they have better relationships. And may their birthday be a wonderful bash of love and of joy. We also pray for all those celebrating their anniversary of marriage. Lord, we pray for stronger bond and stronger love between them, their spouses, and also their whole family. Provide for all their needs, Lord, and may you renew their love for one another. All of this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Thank you. Happy birthday. Happy anniversary. Just a few more moments, friends. Please watch this.
Calling all the married couples in the house. Join Lux Love Life Retreat Batch 16 happening on September 28 to 29 at Angels Hills Retreat Center, Tagaytay City. Retreat fee is 4,500 per couple. For more details, feel free to reach Brother Rick and Sistina Nartea at 0917-577-6122. Calling all singles in the house. Join the Free Love, True Love event happening on September 21, 2019, Saturday from 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. at Madison's Event Place, Madison Galleries, Kupang, Muntinlupa City. Be filled by the empowering theology of the body talk by Father Joel Hason. Investment fee is only 500 pesos. For more info, feel free to reach Chris Pavia at 0920-5245-725. Singles, see you there. Again, calling all singles in the house na may hugot sa work, love life at buhay. Well, this event is for you. Join the singles on August 29 at the Feast Center. Registration fee is only 150 pesos. Let your hugots be turned to blessings. See you there. Are you feeling blessed through the feast? Help build the Feast Alabang District to further its mission for a minimum of 1,000 pesos through the iGive Club. To date, we already have more than 165 members. Feel like being one of them? Visit the iGive Club booth for more details. For those who have special intentions, there will be a pray over session that shall follow right after the feast. Thank you so much for your support because we have reached 4,000 followers because of you, Wafa family. Continue to like and share our page to spread the love of Jesus through the Facebook page. So search Wednesday Feast Festival Alabang and click follow to get latest news and updates. Also, for those celebrants of anniversaries and birthday celebrators, please proceed at the back for some giveaways. Thank you so much.
Knowing that failure can happen and doing it anyway. It's not about looking tough and unaffected. It's knowing the fear and what it can do and facing it anyway. It's not about being radical and gung-ho. It's weighing the needs and consequences and persevering anyway. It's not about working hard all day. Knowing why you work hard and persisting all the way. It's not about confronting the challenge. It's knowing its worth and enduring come what may. It's not just the slog of doing it afraid. It's knowing that God is with you when you step out in faith.
4 days. 4 days of being in God's presence. Kerygma Conference, a gathering of God's people gathered in the name of Jesus, so that we together can leave our fears, leave behind our comfort zone, enter our courage zone with God beside us. Because with God, nothing is impossible. Let your bravery kick in.
Bravery isn't careless abandon, neither reckless in portrayal, nor external in expression. Bravery works inside. Bravery knows its foes. Bravery knows that enemies will come and will come to oppose. And beyond the struggle, bravery comes through. For in this life that we live, God is always with. Be bold. Be confident. Be brave.
Time to be brave. Friends, we'd like to usher in the time to be brave. It's Kerygma Conference 2019. Could you please turn to the person beside you and tell that person it's time to be brave. Today, we are formally opening and launching Kerygma Conference 2019 with the theme, Brave. Could you all say brave?
Brave.
Look at the person beside you. Is that person brave? Kung hindi pa, you need to attend this conference. Friends, I'd like to invite you personally on behalf of Brother Bo Sanchez to join Kerygma Conference 2019 Brave. Katulad nitong apat na bumunta dito, na bigla ko lang sinabi bumunta dito at mag-blindfold. Palapakan na muna natin sila. Sila po ang dance men natin. Sino po dito magiging brave para sumama ho sa performing arts? Kulang pa ho sa amin ng sumasayaw. Pag yung kakilala ninyo, ang katabi ninyo, marunong sumayaw, pakisabi sa kanya, sumama ka na. Noong ganyan lahat. Palapakan muna natin sila. Thank you. Friends, let me just be very quick about this. 4 days. How many days? 4 days of transformation. Every year, Light of Jesus throughout the world gathers for praising God, but also to create learning so that we can learn more to gain the dreams that we have. In those 4 days, when is this? November 21, 24, in the SMX Convention Center of the Mall of Asia, we will have plenary sessions, breakout sessions with what international speakers, with industry experts, and well-known speakers to learn practical life skills. Join us, all right, in order to learn much more of this, to learn any of your different endeavors. Next slide, please. Our theme is Brave. Why? Because everything you want is in your courage zone. Everybody say courage zone. Who needs some courage here? Raise your hand. All right. Then I tell you, you need this. Together at Kerygma Conference, we're going to learn about everything to live the life of bravery. Let's all be brave at Kerygma Conference 2019. Brave. Amen. Today, since we are launching the tickets at a special promo price. You can get them with 200 pesos off, plus a free Kerygma Brave t-shirt. All right? So these are what? Discounts and freebies for all those who will buy tickets now. So instead of your 2,200, you can just buy them at 2,000. All right? And that will be 4 days already of this learning event. That's already savings for you. Brothers and sisters, we stage Kerygma Conference with you in mind, your dreams, your passions. Take this chance. After this, go register, buy your ticket, and we will see you on November for Kerygma Conference 2019. Brave. Amen. Let's give a hand to the Lord for this chance to be brave. Friends, were you blessed?
pakisabi, I'm a believer. Yan. Takot pa ba yung katabi mo? Dapat hindi na. Amen. Let's all stand up, everybody. And let us declare God's abundance. Sino dito naniniwala na yayaman siya? Raise your hand. Amen. You gotta believe it, yeah? Tapigin ng katabi, pakisabi, dapat gumagalaw ka rin, pakisabi. Dapat gumagalaw. Hindi lang believe. You need to do something about it, yes? Because if you really believe it, you'll have to do something about it. Alright? Remember yung ganon? You need to really believe it. And if you really believe it, you have to act. Alright? I'm excited for you. Who will be here next week? Are you sure? Who will bring a friend next week? Who will bring a friend next week? Aasahan ko yan, ha? Aasahan ko yan. Because I tell you, next week is communion. It's gonna be amazing. Alright? You wouldn't like to miss next week. Pakisabi naman dun sa apat na nakilala mo, it's great to know you. Pakisabi, it's great to know you. See you next week! Raise your envelopes now, brothers and sisters. This is our love offering. Yung mga hindi pa alam to, we just believe that if God is Lord, He is Lord also of our finances. So kung may, pakisabi sa katabi, mayaman si Papa. Pakisabi, mayaman si Papa. So pwedeng ibigay ni Lord. Amen? Give it to God. Our song is good to me. Is God good to you? Don't you forget it. Are you convicted? Pakisabi, I'm a believer. Say this, Lord Jesus, I believe you will bless me more than I can believe. Bless me more so I can give more, love more, and bless more. This I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Come, brothers and sisters, offer to God.
Sightedness of my vision often hinders me to see your plans for me. I forget that in every season you're the one who's got me through my thick and thin, but you're still so good to me.
There is so much more than what it seems. Lord, you gave me hope, it's all.
loves you. Mama Mary loves you. See you next week.